Hello everyone, this is David from Automotive Press. I have a 2021 Camry all-wheel drive behind me, but I want to use that as a reference point to show you exactly how do you determine if the car or truck is well-made. As you know, manufacturing defect and quality control is very important for me as an automotive engineer, but it's important for you as well because you don't want to buy a car or truck that can break down the road. So how do you figure out from the outside or from the inside in terms of quality control and whether or not paint job, body finish were all done well? So let me show you by taking you into the Camry and show you exactly what I do to figure out if it's well built. It's a beautiful fall time here in the West Coast. A few of these maple leaf fell on this Camry. Beautiful maple leaf here. But anyway, how do you figure out whether something is well built or not? Well, the Camry here is a really good example to show you because this one is built in Kentucky plant, which is one of the best factories in North America in terms of quality and paint finish, and of course, just the overall body integrity. So how do you tell if it's well built? Well, it's easy to show you on this Camry because it's already one of the best cars built in North America or perhaps in the world. And what I do is I look for the gap. I don't mean just the thickness or the width of this gap, but whether or not this stays consistent from the beginning. So the gap has to stay the same width from top all the way to the rest of the panel. And you can tell in this Camry is exactly the same width from the beginning to the end. And if you look carefully, one of the most difficult things to do is to get this curvature correct right at the end of the panel. Here in this particular Camry, you can tell it's a perfection. Just the right amount of curvature on both sides. Oftentimes, this is where they miss. Other manufacturers do not get it right, and it's too pointed or too round, and this part does not line up. So the alignment of the two panels is important. Again, if you kind of look very carefully on this Camry, it's aligned perfectly, and I can put my hands on both sides, and it's at exactly the same height. You don't necessarily have to have a really narrow gap. You see that in the Lexus, but it's more that it's consistent. That's the most important thing. So you can do that from the hood to the front fender, also the front fender to the doors. These gaps are also very important, sometimes hard to get it right. So again, on this Camry, it's a very well-aligned panels. Perfection, really. Look how close this is and how tightly the actual gaps are. I do have a caliper to measure the actual gap. I'm not going to do that right now, but you can tell just by looking at the eye, these curvature are especially hard to get it right. And this one is, again, near perfection. The other important thing is, of course, the paint job. The paint job is always harder to figure out without the proper lighting because in the auto manufacturing plant, they have a bright light coming in to the panels and you can really see the defects, so we can't do that right now. But even if you're just gonna kneel down carefully and look through the reflection, you can tell from the front to back whether or not the paint is reflected properly and consistently all the way through. Now, if you see some wobbles or some warp, it's not always a paint job problem. It could be the body panels itself not aligned, like the body panels coming out of the stamping shop maybe wasn't done right, and sometimes you see a little bit of warp. But again, in this Camry, it's difficult to see in the black, of course, but you can really see clearly the paint job is very consistent. You don't see any kind of imperfection anywhere, and it's just a very consistent paint. I wouldn't suggest black paint, generally speaking, for most of you who wants to keep things simple. It's just so hard to maintain black paint. But on this Camry, they've done a beautiful job, of course. Now, I will say that Toyota does not necessarily have the thickest paint. Europeans typically have a thicker paint because Toyota is a mastermind of cost cutting, and they'll do anything possible to maximize efficiency as long as they don't compromise quality. So I have measured the paint thickness on a variety of different cars. I use a gauge to measure paint thickness, and it's always a little bit thinner on the Toyotas than European or foreign brands. But all the Japanese brands are about the same. So paint job is excellent. You look for gloss. And then you want to see, especially in the lower panels down here, sometimes the paint job is not done very well. And you can begin to see some glare or issues with the paint on some of the cheaper models from other brands. But on this Camry, again, paint job is excellent. What else can I tell you about auditing or evaluating the body finish? Well, actually the most difficult thing to do is the paint matching between plastic components and metal components. So between like here and here, oftentimes the paint job does not match in many, many models and many brands. That's because these plastic bumpers and other plastic parts are painted in a different part of a factory, or they might come from a vendor or supplier, and therefore it's a little harder to match. But here in the black paint, of course, it's easy to match, so I don't see any differences. But even in the Lexus model, I can see some subtle differences when it's a lighter color like a white or a gold or lighter blue. You can really tell. But some brands do better than others. So here again, in the Toyota model, the paint matching between plastic components and metal components are near perfect. It's really hard to tell the difference. So unlike the exterior, the interior is a bit more complicated because you have a lot more vendors and suppliers involved in bringing all the components and parts together. So for example, oftentimes the headliners are built by a different manufacturer or supplier. Things like the steering wheel, the radio components, gear shifter, whatever have you. All these components come from a different set of suppliers, and Toyota has to assemble them together and still maintain the high quality that we expect from Toyota. So that's not an easy thing to do. But as a consumer or as a user or as an owner of a vehicle, what can we do to figure out whether it was built well? Well, the first thing you obviously look for is noise, vibration, and harshness, or NVH we say. So when you take it out for a drive, you have to listen really carefully. Of course, leave the radio off and so forth, and see if you are hearing any kind of squeaks and rattles from things like the pillars, the headliners. That's very common. Coming from a dash is also very common, and then sometime from the center console, you can. Some car even have squeaks and rattles coming from a steering, if you could believe that. And then the door panels are often an issue as well. So what I do is you can just use your fist, but you can also take something like a golf ball or something, and just tap lightly, and see if you can replicate any kind of potential rattles. If something is loose, you'll be able to hear it right away. And here in this Camry, of course, built in Kentucky, it's solid as a rock. I can't replicate any rattles. I didn't hear any rattles while I was driving, and everything sounds solid. So that's one way to figure out. Just tap lightly again, and if you can replicate sort of rattles, those are the type of noise you will likely hear when the car is a bit older and things begin to get loosened. Then those are areas that will cause problems. So that's what I do in terms of the squeaks and rattles. And then I look for seams. So between the panels here and the components, what do I see? And is the gap consistent? And to make sure that the parts are all fitting together well. It's a bit easier for interior components to fit better because even though you're getting it from multiple vendors, they do snap in place and they do have a locating design, so they automatically locate to a particular place. And so that sometimes makes it easier for things to fit in than, let's say, an exterior panels, which are a bit more finicky to deal with. But nevertheless, any issue with sound or fit obviously are most noticeable in the inside because you're inside the car and you'll hear it right away. Any kind of a fit problem outside, well, it's just not as obvious. So again, in this Camry, really well designed. The stitching of all the parts are also well done. Here, you can tell in some brand, they can't even get the stitching correctly done and it's warped. But on all Toyotas and Lexus, it's a perfect stitching here. Now, I do also investigate and figure out things like the software in the infotainment system, but that's for another video perhaps, because I'm not evaluating a software right now. I'm just talking about hardware stuff. Otherwise, the rest is what we call DFA or DFM issue, which stands for Design for Assembly or Design for Manufacturability. It means that when engineers were designing components, whether it's this part of the steering, or the infotainment system or the buttons. They have to make sure that it's reasonably easy to assemble and manufacture, because no matter how good the design is, if it's difficult to assemble and put together, you're going to get issues in the production. And Toyota does a really fantastic job of that, because their design engineers and production engineers work closely together in a room called Obeya, which means large room, in what we call synchronous engineering style. And so by doing it that way, all of the engineers and designers work together for a same common purpose. And so they are able to point out issues with each other, whether it's a panel fit or a plastic issue or leather or other surface issues. And they can work together to solve the problem quickly. And that way the parts come together as one integrated unit, as opposed to seven or eight different parties or departments working independently and trying to make it fit, which sometimes happens with other manufacturers. So those are really interesting things about the interior. And once again, in this Kentucky-built Camry, I can't really find any fault with it. Yes, maybe it doesn't look like it's a high-end model by any means, but in terms of quality of the interior, the fit and finish, it is definitely high-end.